Buenos días and good morning. How's it going? I know it's a little cloudy today, but it's going to start getting a lot more fun now that we've started. So I have several announcements before we begin. Tengo varios anuncios antes que empecemos. Is it again a go for the outdoor? Okay. All right. I did not realize this was a yearly thing. So next Sunday, we are worshiping outdoors in the lawn behind by the parking lot, weather permitting. Nosotros no me di cuenta, pero nosotros sí vamos a hacer el servicio afuera, al aire libre, cerca del estacionamiento, si hay buen tiempo. All right? We do cover dish, so bring food, traigan comida, y después del servicio comemos. And afterwards, we'll eat. Yes? Muy bien. Same time.
Yeah, we got to have. That's a tradition. You can't sit down.
That's fine. All right. We have metal chairs, but I would recommend you bring some comfy chairs. Okay, recomiendo que traigan sillas flexibles, cómodas, si quieren. And then, of course, you might have a hat, sunscreen, sombrero, whatever. All right. Today is our district conference. This is for Monica, Pastor Laura, myself, and Jenny. Remember, we have that at 3 o'clock today at Manchester First. Monica here? Monica wants that. Muy bien. All right. Okay, youth meetings. Y'all are still meeting on Wednesday nights, correct? Even though these dinners are over. Do you know what time that is? So the president, listen, the vice president looks over at the secretary. Okay.
They were talking about meeting at different houses also, so that's still in the plan. That's still in the works.
Oh, okay. We need to meet this Wednesday because I gotta have y'all help me work on the downstairs stuff and get your input. Okay? So y'all decide and have TJ and text everything. Okay? That's your goal. Alright. Hablamos de los jóvenes. Los jóvenes necesitan marcar el día 17 de junio para el Festival de Moonpie. You need to mark June 17th for the Moonpie Festival for our fundraiser. So make sure that's Saturday. Also, we have Summer Sizzler coming up July 21st, 23rd, we got to think about. So, también el Summer Sizzler el 21 a 23 de julio. So, and then finally, the other announcement I was going to talk about is that I'm working on revising our Safe Sanctuaries policy based on our training recently and other trainings I've had. I'm going to be emailing many leaders in the church the Safe Sanctuaries draft that I'm typing so that you may review it. So if you do, please review it. It is quite long, but please do read it and let me know what I can do, what we might be able to do to add or supplement or whatever. It won't be anything official until the trustees make it official. So we're just working on it together, okay? Soy abogado de la policía de Santuarios Seguros. Yo estoy creando nuevo formato y les voy a mandar a algunos líderes de la congregación para darme más opiniones. Are there any other announcements that I have left out or that you need to give? ¿Hay otros anuncios? Oh, claro. I almuerzo después del servicio. Also, Karina has made lunch for everyone. To celebrate Alexandra's 16th birthday, right after church. Everyone welcome, todos bienvenidos. Yes, so don't forget that, sorry.
Okay, I got one, just quickly. Today is gonna be a different day for our music. We're going to unplug.
Vamos a hacer algo diferente con la música. Vamos a tocar acústicamente.
We are going to be using this thing, dust off the, not the dust off. We're going to have us hymn sing this moment.
Vamos a estar usando los himnarios.
We got some of our band members on the way, so this is a good time that we can get back to our roots. And Alan is going to wow us for all.
Were there any other announcements before we start? people to walk around the room and greet one another in the peace and love of Christ, the Bible that you still stand on the song.
Oh,
A esta hora vamos a compartir nuestras peticiones de oración frente a Dios y los demás. At this time, we will lift up our prayers before God and one another, and our requests and our praises. And just because I always have lots of questions and not a problem, a wonderful thing. Update on my wife and the baby for a month now, postpartum. Again, we think is doing well. She seems to be. She'll go back to the doctor tomorrow. Olivia is doing very well. So Megan está haciendo bastante bien. Vamos a ver la médica mañana. Pero Olivia está muy bien. Sin problema. She's eating a lot. So, ella come mucho. Pero duerme bien. She's sleeping 5 hours at night. Even in college, I was not this sleepy. All right, what prayer requests would you like to read this morning? I'll start over here. Ella.
Well, first I have a praise that Laura, that came through her surgery successfully and seems to be well on the way to getting better. And so thank you very much all of your prayers.
Laura's doing great after surgery. Laura's tuvo éxito con su cirugía.
Pray for her continued recovery and
she hopes. Y seguimos orando por ella. We keep praying for her. Jim. All right, so pray for Ken Hastings and his family, a friend of Jimmy. Ken passed away last week. Oraciones por la familia Hastings, que conoce Jimmy, una familia que está en Florida, porque Ken falleció esta semana pasada.
Yeah. Also, Kelly's wife, Amanda, her grandmother passed away yesterday.
Joey Simmons' mother-in-law,
grandmother-in-law,
passed away as well. What was her name?
Miss
Trot. La señora Trot y la familia Simmons oramos porque Joey, el hijo de Jimmy, la abuela de su esposa falleció. Praises for the band for doing hymns this morning. It makes our souls sing. Gracias a Dios por la música del escenario esta mañana que nos hace nuestro espíritu zen. Any other requests? Oh, okay. I will jack in and I'll come back to the
Well, that is husband already. Su prima y su marido tuvieron un accidente de carro y están en el hospital con la ICU. Yes.
I'd like to give a praise and a serious prayer request. First of all, I praise God. First, I praise God for the last six out of the last eight Saturdays. The abortion bill I stand at in Nashville has been closed since I'm past eight Saturdays. Generally on Saturdays I'll see anywhere from a dozen to 35 cars coming to my business. So I thank God that I believe prayers, street preaching, testifying, and peaceful protests make a difference. This vile place known as the women's. Thank God for that. Serious prayer request. I ask you all to pray further. This vile business known as the Women's Center with an abortion bill in Nashville be shut down permanently. And I am praying to see it done this year. Agree with us. Amen.
Let me translate that. Los seis de los últimos ocho sábados ha sido cerrado el Centro para Mujeres, que dice que es un sitio donde pasan muchos abortos. Que es por gracias a Dios que seis de los ocho sábados ha sido cerrado, pero oraciones que puede cerrar indefinitivamente.
We need prayers, I think, for the web school class of 2017.
Yes.
They are on their annual camping trip. Let us pray they don't get eaten by a bear. And so that Eric can preach over next Saturday morning.
Yes, prayers for me as I have to go and give a speech for web school's graduation, and that they are not eaten by bears. Oraciones por los de web que se van a graduar sábado y por mi presentación que tengo que dar durante su semana. Alright. At this time, we will take all these prayers, lift them up before the Lord as we pray together. Oremos. O God, who are Father, Creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, Redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, you who are Holy Ghost, Sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, Blessed, and Glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Lord, remember not our offenses, nor the offenses of our forefathers, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, Lord, and spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. From all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the crafts and assaults of the evil one, and from everlasting damnation, deliver us. Deliver us from blindness of heart, pride, vainglory, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all want.
of others. From all inordinate and sinful affections, from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and evil, from false doctrine, heresy, schism, hardness of heart, and contempt of your own word, Lord, deliver us. We pray that you would bless and keep your people, that you would send forth laborers to do your harvest, and to draw all humankind into your kingdom, that it may be pleasing to you to give all people an increase of grace to hear and receive your word, and to bring forth the fruits of the Spirit. We pray that it would please you to make all wars cease, to give nations unity, peace, and concord, and to bestow freedom upon all peoples. We pray that it may please you to show your pity upon prisoners, captives, homeless and hungry, those who are desolate and oppressed. We pray that it may please you to give and preserve to our use the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that in due time all may enjoy them. We pray that you would release us to preserve, provide for all children and child, all women in childbirth, young children and orphans, the widow, and all those whose homes are broken or torn by strife. We pray that it may please you that we visit the lonely, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, and spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm. We pray that it may please you that we support, help, and comfort all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation. We pray all of these things that you would lift up the fellowship of this church at Belbuckle, all those who visit and are part of other churches here or all over the world. Lord, we pray that you would hear us, that you would take away the sins of the world. Lord, have mercy upon us. We pray all these things boldly in the name of Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Will the ushers please come forward to collect today's offering? Padre Celestial, te damos gracias por todos los bienes, todos los recursos, por la vida misma, por cada minuto que nos das. Te suplicamos que nos sigas para que podamos ser tus manos y pies aquí en este mundo, a través de nuestra vida, incluyendo a través de nuestro dinero. Eso oramos que todo pueda ser para la edificación de tu reino aquí en la tierra como en el cielo. Amén.
Thank you.
children's church. At this time, we invite all the children who wish to come and participate in children's church, where they will be in the fellowship hall, just down the hallway, and they will have their own worship experience during this time. So what we're doing now is they know to get ready for prayer. Just so you know, if you ever had a kid who didn't want to go, they want to stay in here, they're welcome to do that. Okay, just so you know. But they love it. So let's all line up and get somewhere in the altar. Here, on our way. There's so many, we may have to get a bigger altar. Okay. All right, you all ready to pray? ¿Están listos para orar? All right. Oremos. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the little ones. We know that in our society we teach that the elders know everything and the kids don't know anything. Lord, we pray that you would flip this on its side. Lord, we pray that your spirit would go and fill these children, that they may be full of your love and wisdom. That as we teach them the ways of the world and the history and scripture, that they might be able to teach us as well about who you are, about how we should be and how we should treat one another. Lord, we pray that children and adults in this church could continue learning and growing together. In Christ our Lord, whose name we pray. Amen. All right, y'all are dismissed.
Is this good? The choosing of the seven. In those days, when the number of disciples was increasing, the Hellenistic Jews among them complained against the Hebraic Jews because their widows were being overlooked in the daily distribution of food. So the 12 gathered all the disciples together and said, "It would not be right for us to neglect the ministry of the Word of God in order to wait on tables. Brothers and sisters, choose seven men from among you who are known to be full of the Spirit and wisdom. We will turn this responsibility over to them and will give our attention to prayer and the ministry of the Word." This proposal pleased the whole group. They chose Stephen, a man full of faith and the Holy Spirit. Also Philip, Porus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas from Antioch to convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles who prayed and laid their hands on them. So the word of God spread. The number of disciples in Jerusalem increased rapidly, and a large number of the priests became obedient to the faith.
Personally, I think that always it's a great privilege to preach the God's word, but also it's a great responsibility. Please pray. Heavenly Father, we are here because you love us first, but we love you also. We are ready to hear your word. Please, Holy Spirit, speak to all of us. Dios, te damos gracias porque estamos en este lugar para alabarte, estamos en este lugar para bendecirte y también para escuchar tu voz. Santo Espíritu, te pedimos que seas tú el que hable y que toque nuestros corazones y nos transformes a la imagen de Jesucristo. En el nombre de Jesús. Amén. And I want to start focus in the beginning of the Christian church according to what we have learned from the book of us until now. If we remember in chapter 1, the church started with 120 people in the upper room. And also, they remained in Jerusalem because was Jesus' command. In that city, we remember that they were baptized by the Holy Spirit. The first intention of this was to preach the mystery of faith. And the first Sunday of the month, we remember the mystery of faith, which is Christ has died, Christ has risen, and Christ will come again. So the result of this message was a fast growth of the church. If we remember the first Peter's sermon, how many people converted? Yes, right, 3,000. 3,000 people received Jesus Christ as their Savior. But the second Peter's sermon, 5,000 people received Jesus Christ as their Savior. Therefore, I can say that an important word in the book of Acts is growth. This word leads us a question. And the question is, what are the elements of the growing? And I can see three. At least in this chapter 6, I can see three. First of all, the disciples realized the necessity of the community. Second, they appointed the appropriate men. And finally, the apostles were very focused in their call. Well, let's see. The beginning of the church was during the Pentecost day in Jerusalem. And because the Pentecost was a Jewish festivity, that day were Jews who were living in Palestine. But were Jews who were born and living in other countries as well. Therefore, we can say that the early church was a mixture of these groups. The passage says that were Hellenistic Jews. This is very important thing. But also, it means that they were Jews whose their first language was Greek. The other group was Hebrew Jews. It means that they speak Hebrew as their first language. It's very obvious that Greek and Hebrew are very different languages. It's very, very obvious. But I would like to stop here and point out the first teaching in these first verses of the chapter 6. And I found that since the very beginning of the Christian church, God's desire is to see different cultures worship together and establish his kingdom. And for me, it's very important, and also I'm amazed with this fact, because this is a reality here in the Bible, 2,000 years later. It's a reality in this church. And also this church belongs to Jesus Christ, right? The Baptist United Methodist Church belongs to Christ. No pastor it is, no me, no the Bishop Matali. This church belongs to Jesus Christ. So in this church, there are two different groups worship God together. One group speaks English, and the other speaks Spanish. And also, we want to establish the kingdom of God in our surroundings, in our community. The question is, are we aware of the necessities of our community? The early church realized that the Greek widows were not being taken care of. The first people action was to complain about it. However, this is not the best way to solve the problem. When there is a problem, it's very important to talk to the right person. For example, I remember that 2 months ago, there were a power outage in our street here in Mexico. It was very early. So therefore, we made a phone call to the Dog River Company because they are in charge of the electricity issues. And perhaps somebody else called them before us because very soon, very quickly, a man appeared on the street and he fixed the problem. So when we look over the passage, we noticed that the apostles solved the problem because they were the right persons to do it. The apostles, the 12 apostles, saw the situation and talked to the church, and they recommend or they recommend to the church special suggestions for solve this problem. So sometimes, a few times, we have some special situation in our church. When this happens, please talk with the right person, with Pastor Eric, with the leaders of the church, or with me. I think it's the best way to solve some special situation, as the 12 apostles did that time. And what was the problem? Well, what was the situation? Well, the passage is very clear about it. The 12 disciples looked for men with specific qualities and gifts to give an answer to the necessity of the community. But something is special in this passage. If we notice, 6 names of the men were Greek names. And this is important. It's very important. Some Bible commentaries says that probably all of these men were Greek Jews. Why? Because there were Greek widows in necessity. It means that these men knew the language, knew the culture, and they can relate it with these Greek widows in a better way than the Hebrew Jews. That's one of the reasons. But also, more important is that these men had a very good testimony. Also, they needed to be full of the Holy Spirit, and they needed to be wise men. These characteristics talk about of men who love God, but also men who love the neighbor. These talents and qualities also are for the leaders of the church. And Apostle Paul stresses them again in his letter to Titus, these characteristics. It's very important to be aware that the standards of Christian people and also the standards of the leaders of the church are high. And these are the qualities and the talents that people in leadership of the church need to show. It's very important because the apostles have a very special, very specific mission to do. This This mission was to be in prayer, but also they needed to preach. That's the focus of the disciples. That's the reason that they saw the situation and they talked to the congregation, and the congregation appointed specific people to help with the ministry, because they needed to be focused in prayer and preaching. I was thinking about that, and I think that as pastors, we need to spend more time in prayer. First thing in prayer, and second, in preaching. I don't know, but sometimes we need a long time of prayer as pastors. Do you remember the last time that I preached? I mentioned about the John Hyde, and I was surprised because at the end of the worship service, a man approached me and he said, "I know that biography. I know about that man. Do you remember that that man has spent sometimes 25 hours in prayer?" It's difficult, but I think as pastors, it's very important to spend time in prayer. It's very important. Can you imagine? I'm not sure how many people are here today. Maybe something like that. Maybe. I don't really know the numbers, but can you imagine if Pastor Eric and I can be focused in each of you? How many time do we need to spend in all of you? In a real prayer, because I can pray, God please bless all the Bembara Church and that's it. But no, we need to spend a real time of prayer in you. That's the reason that the apostles needed help from the church. And to be honest, sometimes we don't do. Unfortunately, the United Methodist Church is a Christian. Why? Maybe because as pastor, we are very busy in many things. Not only here in the church, but in the district, in the conference, and others. Where is time of prayer? Prayer is our first mission. The United Methodist Church is increasing in this country because we are very focused in studies. And please don't understand me. The studies are very good, but the first thing is to be in communion with God. This is the most important thing. One day, I heard someone say, prayer is the backbone of the Christian life. And I believe that. I believe that. Today, when we saw the Christian history, we can see many people spending time with God in prayer. Do you remember Martin Luther, the great reformer? His biography says that he spent at least 5 or 8 hours in prayer every day. I remember others, maybe you remember others, but one of the women that impacted my life was Catherine Coleman. I'm not sure how many of you are familiar with this day, but she spent many times in prayer. And people accept Jesus Christ as their Savior. What happened now? The gospel, at least in this country, is spreading very fast because we have technology. However, people are rejecting the gospel. There is a problem and we need to fix. As a church, we need a task to do. And Pastor Eric and I, we need your help as the first disciples do in the very beginning of the Christian church. It's important to see 1 Corinthians 12:5-11. I'm sure that this passage is very familiar from most of you, but I would like to read it. There are different kinds of service by the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them and in everywhere, it is the same God at work. Now, to each on the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common God, common good. To one, there is given through the Spirit a message of wisdom. To another, a message of knowledge by means of the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by that one Spirit. To another, miraculous powers. To another, prophecy. To another, distinguish between spirits. To another, speaking in different kinds of tongues. All these are the work of one and the same Spirit. And he distributes to each one just as he determines. So the Holy Spirit empowered that man for a specific task. It's the same Holy Spirit that empowered to continue to build the kingdom of God in this time, in this church, in this community, through us. In this church, there are many ministries that we need help. If some of you are not sure about what is your talent or your gift or your calling, please pray to God about it. But also, please call the pastor for giving, and we can pray to God, and we can help you to discover your talent. Because it's very important that people is focused in their talent. It's time, my dear brothers and sisters, it's time to work together. It's time to continue to do the mission of God as one body. As one body. As we see in chapter 6 of the book of Acts. Two different cultures since the very beginning of Christian church worship God together and establish the kingdom of God together. That's all. Heavenly Father, thank you because today you have spoken to us, maybe in a very soft way, but I'm very sure that the Holy Spirit is talking to us. Please, awake us. We need you. You are coming again for Jesus Christ. You are coming again for your church. But you are giving time to others to enter to your family. Give us the courage to do it. Sometimes we don't know how to do it. But teach us and help us. pray for this congregation. Thank you because you are the Lord of this church. And help us to love you more. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Give us opportunities to share with you. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.